ISUPK.
Hey, Salam, man. It's Priest Kevin Gondonhall with the ISUPK. And a commander journey in Atlanta in California, man. To all blacks, Hispanics, and Native Indians. Subscribe to this channel, man. You want true salvation? You're going to learn from the priests and prophets of the ISUPK, man. Subscribe to that channel. Hit that button, man. And it's there with that. Salam.
We want no cowards in our camp, in our camp.
Isaiah 30:9. This Bible is the blueprint for black excellence. Everybody want to talk about what can we do as a people to better our people. Well, we've been avoiding the solution all along. We've been avoiding the answer to black on black crime. We've been avoiding the answer to drug addiction. We've been avoiding the answer to rape and child molestation and mental illness and depression and suicide and all types of ills and woes that we suffer in the black and Hispanic communities. This Bible is all about black supremacy. The Bible is about black supremacy. And the reason why you don't know it is because of the filthy pimps in these churches and that lying imam in the mosque.
Right.
You understand? Read this. This is why the Bible told us that when we tell the truth, not to spare anyone's feelings. Start at verse 1.
Isaiah chapter 30, verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children.
Anybody know what the word woe means? Woe is Old English for destruction. And the God of the Bible is saying destruction to the who?
To the rebellious children.
Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans have become who?
Rebellious children.
Because we follow after America and their culture, we have become who?
Rebellious children.
Because we decide to be Christian and Muslim and Democrats and Republicans and Seventh-day Adventists and Baptists and all types of denominations, God calls us who?
Rebellious children.
The Lord is saying destruction to us, black man, Hispanic man, Native American, Indian man. And if you don't believe this Bible is real, you just open your damn eyes to every ghetto in the United States, and black people live in the same jacked up conditions wherever we are. Because the Lord has brought upon us destruction for being rebellious, for going against what he told us to do in this Bible. This Bible gives us the blueprint on how to deal with each other, on how to conduct ourselves in this oppression, man. And we decide that we don't want to follow what this book says. We better off living how America lives. What's the saying? They say, when in Rome, do as the Romans.
Right.
Well, the Romans were gay.
Right.
I hate to break it to you. You understand? That's just the gateway into you being gay and a drug addict and strung out and violated. When in Rome, do as the Romans. That's garbage, man. When in Rome, do as the Lord says. When in Egypt, do as the Lord says. When in Greece, do as the Lord says. When in America, do as the Lord says, man. This is why the Lord is saying destruction to the rebellious children, to our people, man. You understand? Keep reading.
Saith the Lord that take counsel, but not of me.
We take counsel from all avenues except the Lord. We go to that Christian pastor. You understand? Especially if you're in a black and Hispanic community, as a black woman or Hispanic woman, that's mainly who you're getting counsel from, is that lying snake in the pulpit. You understand? You go and whatever he says is law. The pastor says you can abort your baby for your career. You understand? What God says, that's wrong. The pastor says you can leave that man in your house that you're sleeping with because he doesn't have a job. God says that's wrong. The pastor says, don't worry about this child being, I didn't molest that child. You can't believe these kids. You know that she was fast anyway. And God says he's a filthy liar and a hypocrite and a sinner. We take counsel from Steve Harvey. We take counsel from Creflo Dollar, T.D. Jakes. We take counsel from black leaders who could give a damn about black people. And that's why the Lord is trying to show us, this is why we're destroyed. This is absolutely why we're destroyed. But here's the sad part. Go to verse 10. This is the sad part. You would think our people would want to hear the truth. You would think with us being fed lies by the oppressor in America, by us being lied to for 12 years in his school system, they told us Christopher Columbus discovered America. And then you come to find out that this damn European was a thief and a rapist and a murderer. They told us that the founding fathers of America believed in liberty and justice for all. And then you grow up and find out that they were racist slave owners, man. You would think that we would love to hear the truth. You understand? But this is really who we are as a people. You understand? The Bible tells us who we are as a people and the problem with our people, man. Read.
Verse 10, which say to the seers.
Which say to the who?
To the seer.
A seer is a prophet. You understand? A seer is a prophet. And this is what black, Hispanics, and Native Americans say to the men of the Lord. Read.
And to the prophets, prophesy not unto us right things.
Do what?
Prophesy not unto us right things.
Don't tell us homosexuality is wrong.
Prophesy not unto us right things.
God is all love.
Prophesy not unto us right things.
Well, my pastor and my church, we do things a little different.
Right.
Prophesy not unto us right things.
This is the spirit of the black, Hispanic, and Native American community. We don't want to hear the goddamn truth. We love to hear the lies. That's why the churches are filled to the brim, while the truth, nobody wants to stand for it. You understand? Nobody wants to stand for what's right. And then we moan and complain when we see wrong being done to our people. When as a people, we don't want to hear what's right. You understand? Like in order for our people not to be murdered by the police, in order for us not to have more Trayvon Martins and more George Floyds and more Sandra Bland and more Breonna Taylors and more Emmett Till's and more Black Wall Street, in order for us to not see our people suffer at the hands of these devils, we have to start to love the goddamn truth.
Right.
And what is the truth? That the oppressor is the devil, the Bible speaks of.
That's
and
right.
If you are black, Hispanic, and Native American, you are a child of the God of the Bible.
Right.
You are of the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel. The real Jews.
Good.
That's the truth according to this Bible. And the moment that we can stop hating lies, stop loving lies, and stop hating the truth, we can change our community. We can fix our community. But the problem is, we have a bad thing for liking what's good for us. As a people, we don't want what's good for our people. We rather continue to live in America in the on the bottom, the laughing stock of the world. You understand? You love to see when these oppressors go to the cookouts and do all the dances with us, when they just come in to have a little fun with the slaves. And then they leave and go back to the house while you a slave still. You understand? These people only join with us when it's fun and beneficial for them. And the moment when it's time for our people to change our conditions, they're nowhere to be found. And that's the spirit of these religious leaders, of our so-called black leaders. They'll join when it benefits them, when it's good for their reputation and for their name. But when it's time to really put boots to the ground and sacrifice for our people, where are the religious leaders? Where's the pastor? If your pastor is so special and different, why the hell is he not on the corner talking about the truth?
Right.
To the people that are on the corner. You understand? Because he could give a damn about blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. He could give a damn about our people and our suffering and our struggle. They collecting all your tithes money and all your grandmama tithes money and we living in the ghettos with rats and roaches while they driving foreign cars. And then on top of that, this is how much they hate you. They brag about it to you. I just bought this new car. I got the gators on. I got a five-piece suit. They mock us, man. They mock us because we love lies. And the pastor understood well.
I roll with warriors and them garments be looking glorious. Feel like 20 sets of fists hitting you, but it's four of us. They always scream squad, but loyalty just mean more to us. Let the 40s bust when it's time, unleash the hunters. I done seen stand up niggas turn into runners. Niggas with weak right hooks turn into gunners. Soldiers in abundance, marching in by the hundreds. We don't hold no punches, we letting them go in bunches. Crawled up out the dungeons and now we do it humongous. Waiting on a hater to flex, we doing lunges. Rappers better give me respect, this beat punished. Really, I don't worry about credit or where it's due. Just know your favorite rapper, a toilet, I'm number two. Camp full of animals like I'm running the zoo. Call me Tower Warhawk, either call me the Jew. Shit, you can call me the king, I'm ready to rule. Only sharks swim here, rappers get out the pool. Only real spitters can wade in this type of water. A renaissance coming, we cutting your time shorter. You had a good while to get your affairs in order.